On this episode of Mod Guide, The Factory from Mekanism. Greetings, it's Vaygrim, back again with another episode of Mod Guides. This time I'd like to look at the factories from Mekanism. Now, Mekanism, a mod by Aidan C. Brady, has many different things that it can do, many different machines that it does it with, but I'm going to focus specifically on the factories today. Now, factories are basically upgraded versions of normal machines. I believe there's somewhere between 10 to 12 different machine blocks. I think maybe more if you count power generation machines. But there's about a dozen or so machine blocks. Six of those machines can be upgraded into what are called factories. Now, factories are basically souped-up versions of those same machines. You get multiple processes that you can do at the same time. This is a compressor. I can actually have three separate things being compressed at once. This is an upgraded osmium combining machine. I'm sorry. Osmium compressor combiner. That's a basic factory, tier one. There's the smelting machine, all the way down to the crusher or the purifier. So many machines. Now these four are going to be, the reason I have them separated, is that these four are going to be the main ones you're going to end up dealing with the most, because you're going to be upgrading them as much as you can for your basic ore processing. The purifier, the crusher, the enricher, and the smelter. Now, I think a smelter factory would be a really good place to start. The problem is, it's kind of hard to get down into these little machines. So, I made this for us to explore. Yeah. So, basically, this factory is a tier one machine. There's three tiers total. And the tier one machine means, wow, that's big, that it is the bottom level, but it's still better than a basic machine. Now, this, as I said, let's consider this a smelting factory, would have three different channels that it can do things with, three processes it can do at once, represented by these three rail lines. It goes and it takes the stuff that it is processing and then outputs it for you. Three separate tasks all happening in parallel. Now, as you can see above, there's still space to upgrade this basic factory into an elite factory. I'm sorry, basic to advanced, which would mean that it could do not three, but five processes. And I'll show you that right now. Now, you have all of these basic machines. These are basic versions. They're not even factories. These are the core machines themselves. The core machine blocks. Purification chambers, crusher, the enrichment chamber, and the energized smelter. And then over here, again, I said the strange ones. They do have a purpose and mechanism, but their purpose is a little bit more off to the side. The osmium compressor is used to make the specialty metals, glowstone ingots, and refined obsidian ingots that are a part of mechanism. The combiner is used to basically recombine ore and stone back into an actual ore block, among other things. But that's one of the weird uses for it. So, basically, these are the core machine blocks. One process at a time. Battery storage slot. Progress meter. Output. This is the power storage. And this right over here is what's called the upgrade slot, basically. The upgrade area. Of course, these machines respond to redstone controls also, but most times I don't even worry about them. I just let them go. And each one of these machines is basically laid out the same way. Not very far off when it comes down to it. Now, there's also this button up here, configuration. And what this does basically is it lets you configure exactly how you want this machine to interact with its environment around it. Now let me show you something real quick. This is something that Aidan C. Brady has put in. The configurator, which is the premier tool within Mekanism. It gets used for everything. Just pick up your configurator. You don't even have to click. Just hold your mouse pointer over there. Dark red. See, I'm colorblind, folks. I'm as colorblind as it comes. So I can't actually tell what coloration this slot is or this one. But now I know dark red, dark blue, purple, dark green, orange, etc., etc., etc. Now I can go up here. I know red is the input, dark red. Dark blue is the output. And if you want to, you can left-click to advance this. Just like that. Right-click to go backwards, basically. Left-click goes forwards. Or if you shift-left-click, it resets it to gray, basically turning it off. Shift-left-click, very, very useful. So, right now this machine is set to take stuff in from the top, but of course there's nothing up there right now. And it kicks it out the side. This machine is set to take it in from the side and inject the results out its side to the next machine, and so on and so forth. So what I can do right now is get a single piece of osmium ore. What the purification chamber does is it uses flint to purify your ore and turn it into not one, not two dust, but literally three. Then that, those three clumps have to be basically crushed up and made usable by the crusher. It then gets enriched in the enriching chamber so it can then be turned into an ingot. So these four machines will triple your ore yield for pretty much every ore out there. It works for lead, it works for tin, copper, iron, gold, osmium. For the most part, I think most standard ore that most mods have, it's going to work. Now, it might not work for exotic ores. Things like metallurgy adds a lot of ore that just isn't supported by a lot of other mods. And unfortunately, that is kind of the case here as well. But everything else, it'll really hit a home run. Now, we have all of these in the energized smelter right now. And we got not two, but three ingots for our trouble. Now, I'm going to show you all of those machines and their upgrade slots. The purification chamber, right? You have speed, S, and you have energy, or E. Now, the tooltips on these are backwards, but they do work. It's a simple error. Basically, if I get these speed upgrades, you'll see this S will click up two times, three times, four times, and it gets faster and faster. Basically, what that's doing is it's speeding up the base processing speed of the machine itself, how it operates, how quickly and how efficiently it operates. Now, it can take a maximum of 8 upgrades, which means it goes from 1 to 9 times as fast. And I can do this on all of these machines. I'm just going to plug these in here, and they'll slowly absorb them. I'll show you. I'll come back to this crusher. See, the crusher is taking them all in. And you remember how long it took for one piece of ore to get from A to B. I'm going to show you. Is this one done now? Purification chamber. Crusher. Enrichment chamber. Smelter. And done. That's 9 upgrades, ladies and gentlemen. That was fast. Now, that's just the basic machines, and I promised you factories. You can get any machine like these, and you can turn them into a basic factory. A little bit of upgrades, and you basically make it to where each machine is processing three things at once instead of just one. You can get your basic factory and upgrade it into an advanced. See, a little bit more upgrades, a little bit more resources, but you turn it into an advanced. An advanced, you can turn into an elite factory. Now, you're thinking, what's the differences? Well, a basic factory has three things it can process at a time, three parallel pipelines is one way to think about it. An advanced factory has 5. And you guessed it, the elite factory has 7. Count them. 7 slots. that you can use in tandem for whatever you want. And I can show you. Now, here's one of the key features that a lot of people don't actually pay attention to. This S right over here. You see, I only filled up one slot on this. It's not making peak usage of all these other parallel slots. But if I turn on auto sort, it automatically divvies out the load to all the slots on the machine. Everything gets processed in parallel. You're basically processing 7 times more efficiently than you normally would. And look how quickly it's ripping through all of that. So, that covers a lot of the basics, but I'm going to show you this little setup that I've made right here. This little setup right here is 4 fully upgraded elite factories. Now what that means, 7, that's 7 parallel lines that they can process on. I have auto sort turned on, which means it's automatically going to distribute everything within. They're going to auto eject their goods down to the next machine. This one will pass it off to the one to the right. This one sends it to the one above, and this one kicks it out to this chest. So basically what I have here is a fully upgraded and fully capable ore processing line, and I've got a chest full of ore. So what I'm going to do is flip the switch, and you will see, watch this pipe right here, a steady stream of ore, just ingots pouring out of that. What this is basically doing is processing ore almost faster than it can actually receive it. This machine is processing as much as it can, as quick as it can. This same thing, enriching chamber, then smelting finally to a steady stream of gold ingots. Now, one stack of ore going through this process yields 3 stacks of ingots because I'm tripling. This machine, which is running out of flint, the purifier uses flint in order to give you 3 ore, which then must be processed by these 2 machines before finally getting smelted. So, it's a real good setup. I'm gonna shut that down. And this is gonna catch up real quick. We'll wait for the noise to subside. Oh, come on. There's not that much, is it? Oh, whatever. So, here's the thing. A lot of people don't realize there's one key feature that these factories have that can actually be very, very useful early game, and it's this right here. This is a smelting factory, right? Well, I'm going to pull out a crusher and turn this machine into a crushing factory. Now, let me do that again. Crushing factory becomes a smelting factory. It's very critical. It's very, very critical. Early game, you might not have enough to be able to actually upgrade multiple factories. You're probably going to turn one machine at a time from an ordinary model to a basic factory model. And what this means is that if you have to do some quick processing of a specific kind, you can just swap machines inside of a factory and make it do something else. Now I can go down to this elite factory down here, which is loaded with gold for some reason. This is an enriching chamber. I have one elite factory that I have now swapped out and turning it into a energized smelter. And I'll change it back. This is one really amazing feature that is often overlooked in these blocks. And I think it's mainly because a lot of people don't even know that's what this is for. They don't even have a clue. Now, one other thing I'm also going to show you, I'm going to put that back, and get rid of some of my clutter. I have machines that are upgraded now. You can go up here and remove speed upgrades. And if I had energy upgrades, I could click on here. It says speed, but the tooltips are backwards. If I had speed upgrades in the machine and energy upgrades, I could actually remove them. Now, this means that you can not only upgrade machines, you can juggle the upgrades between machines. Combine that with the fact that you can actually juggle functionality between factories as well as your upgrades, and you have a lot of flexibility with these machines. A lot of people don't know that these can do so much. Now, there is one part about all of this that I'm not going to touch this time around, which is the input-output function right here in the configuration screen and strict input. All of this ties together into one big feature. Basically, if I flag this, then anything that this machine sends out gets flagged. Actually, I think I can show you. Let me get some iron ore. I'll go over here. Dark blue output. What I'm going to do, and you watch, you see every single one of those iron ingots coming out is being flagged to the blue blocks, box, blue blocks, yay. What that means is that if I have a sorting system that uses the logistical sorter from Mekanism, as well as the logistical transport pipes, which is what these are, also from Mekanism, you can tie it all together in a precision color coordinated system. Things go specific places that you want them to go, and they only go to those places. That's what this feature is. Only certain slots will only take certain colors. So if I have blocks coming out of another machine that have been flagged blue, they will go in to this machine through the top based upon what this slot is. So if I say this is the input slot for processing, anything flagged blue will come in here. It's very, very good, but it is a very deep feature that I'm going to leave for another time when we tackle the logistical sorters on another episode of Mod Guides. Now, I think this is a pretty good wrapping up point, but I know that there's more to these things that people really aren't even considering. They have a lot of uses, a lot of flexibility. And you don't even have to make that many different variations of the machine. You really only need, for your entire ore processing line, four factories that you just upgrade and upgrade and upgrade. Turn them from basic to advanced, advanced to elite. Speed them up. Improve their energy efficiency so they don't hit your power grid as much. That's pretty significant. That's pretty powerful. That means I don't have to have an entire wall of machines to process. One row of elite factories has the same processing power as seven rows of four ordinary machines. That's pretty impressive. On that note, I think this is going to be a good place to stop. I'll let you think upon all of this, and we'll revisit more features of Mekanism that tie into the factory at a later date. Thanks again. Bye.